This is the first video in our Capital Investment Decisions and the Time Value of Money series. And I'd like to go ahead and remind you that we have the lecture notes that we use in these videos on the website at theaccountingdoctor.com. And we encourage you to go download those, print those out while you're watching these videos, and take notes directly from the video. In this first video, we are going to be talking about capital budgeting and briefly introducing the four capital budgeting models. So when we talk about capital budgeting, we're specifically talking about how we budget for the acquisition of our capital assets, so those depreciable assets. There are four models that we can use when discussing capital budgeting decisions. And we'll have videos that will discuss each one of these in more detail. But the first one is the payback period. The second one is the accounting rate of return. The third one is called the net present value model. And the fourth is the internal rate of return. The first two, the payback period and the accounting rate of return, are used for short-term business decisions. This is because these two models ignore the time value of money concept, which we'll get into later on as well. The other two capital budgeting models, net present value and internal rate of return, they focus on long-term business decisions because they incorporate the time value of money concept. Anytime we're considering a capital budgeting decision or investing in a capital asset, we have to focus on the cash flows of that investment. So we have to think about what cash is that investment going to bring in, or the cash inflows, and what will be the cash outflows because of that investment decision. So let's first talk about the cash inflows that we can see from a capital investment. For example, the future cash revenues that will be generated from that investment, the future savings in ongoing cash operating costs resulting from the investment. So think about a piece of equipment, a new piece of equipment versus an old piece of equipment. So a new piece of equipment will likely require less operating cost than would an old piece of equipment. Also, you have to think about future residual value. So if you plan on a piece of equipment lasting for 10 years, and at the end of that 10 years, you could sell it for $5,000 or $10,000, that residual value is the same thing as a cash inflow at that time. And the cash outflows due to a capital investment would be that investment's ongoing cash operating cost, refurbishment, repairs, and maintenance cost that are involved with any capital investment, be it equipment, building, whatever. You also have to consider one of the most obvious cash outflows, the cost of that new investment.